we set safety things. But what about passwords? We currently live in the fourth industrial revolution. Everything is now online. Our private texts, our private photos, and even the private things that we don't want other people to see. But a lot of us don't actually take passwords very seriously. In 2017, October, Yahoo had the largest breach of hacking. 3 billion different usernames and passwords were hacked and available online. And because of that, if you have a Yahoo account and password that is affected in the 3 billion, which is basically all of their accounts, hackers will know what your email is, hackers will know who you email, and hackers will know all the different emails that you have sent. However, Yahoo was not the only website that was affected. In fact, there are 325 different websites that are affected. And if you have any of these websites signed up for, you are at risk. Now, raise your hands if you think, I think my account is secure, I'm not affected. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 people, hands down. There's actually a way to find out. There's a project called haveibeenpwned.com. It's an old term meaning that have I been pranked or not. This project looks at all the different hacked website databases. And if you type in at haveibeenpwned.com, type in your email address, it can match your email to that database. And if there's a match, it means that someone knows what your password is. Now, don't bother checking your phones because I have taken the liberty to check all of our members' emails and also women's. In total, there's 17 different emails and 11 of them are under breach. Meaning that, Nabila, you're a guest, whenever you meet one out of two people in this room, one out of two have actually had their passwords hacked. On top of this, the average internet user has 27 different accounts, meaning that if you have Gmail, if you have Facebook, if you have Instagram, you have 27 different accounts. Usually you don't use different passwords for different accounts. Usually you use 3 of the same passwords. Yeah. Now the solution to this is very simple. Use different passwords for different accounts. Well done! Yeah, we've discovered the solution! Yay! But how many of you will go home tonight and actually register different passwords for different usernames? Not really, because have you ever had this situation where you try to log in and you try to log in your password and you're like, okay, password 1 doesn't work, password 2, password 3 doesn't work, password 3, all of them don't work. Maybe I try to type in password 1 again carefully. Oh, I missed out a character, backspace the whole thing. Oh, caps lock is on. Oh, I have to backspace the whole thing. Have you ever had this situation before?
Yes.
Now, there's a problem to all of this. It is that we cannot remember all of our passwords, and our passwords are very prone to typos. Password managers tackle this problem directly by having 2 direct solutions. Number one, instead of having to remember 27 or 100 different passwords, you only had to remember 1 master secure password. Number 2, instead of having to type your passwords, you never have to type your password again because everything is done automatically by the app itself. How does it work? Now, a password manager is something like Google Drive. A Google Drive is, you get a document, type in all the passwords inside, and you upload it to the Google Drive. The problem with that is that it's not really feasible. Meaning that if you type in a new password, the password from your Google Drive does not automatically go there. You have to type the whole thing out. Password managers work in such a way that whenever you type a new password, the password will automatically transfer from your Google Drive to your main account. The second thing is that the passwords have a built-in password generator. How many of us have passwords that are 6 characters long only? No one wants to admit, but 6 character long passwords require about 1 week to decode. It's very simple. However, with a password manager with a built-in password password generator can have password that's very long, so that even if the hackers had control of the Yahoo database and they look at your password, they will not be able to decode it because it's encrypted. The more encrypted it is, the more long it is, the more secure your password. So those are the two things that make password manager very desirable. Number one, it's very convenient. Number two, you don't have to remember passwords ever again. So security is one of the most important things that we take it for granted. It is only at the very last minute when things go wrong where we start to take things very seriously. I urge you to take things very seriously, take your passwords very seriously, and take your personal data very seriously. Use a password manager. Thank you.